Now, the other speakers' nice presentations were made by Aradhana Srivastava. She presented reactions induced by seven lithium beam at our Bombay Pellitron facility, and she showed that the breakup fusion processes are always much larger than the direct breakup mechanism. But of course, these things were known earlier when. But long, long ago, I was working in low-energy breakup reactions. Then we, at that time, we showed that these inelastic breakup processes, which include breakup fusion mechanism, what they call transfer fusion or breakup fusion, or deep, or what many various names they have given to it, is dominant. That we showed already that the direct process is only 20%. 80% time it goes through inelastic. Then Sudhiranjan Banerjee presented also a very nice talk on excitation and decay of giant resonances with alpha beams coming from our cyclotron facility in Calcutta. And then he showed that old horse cyclotron, which is now 25, 30 years old, it is still continues to be useful, and one can do good physics with that. Then nuclear reaction studies with heavy ions at intermediate energies. So very nice talks were presented by Christoph Hartner and Sunil Kumar. Their tool is isospin dependent quantum molecular dynamics. Then there were many posters presented by the students, so which shows that this field, this study using this tool continues to be of great interest to not only to several faculty but also to many students who join this activity, and they are performing these calculations. But there are many, of course, uncertainty which Christoph actually pointed out. The most important uncertainty is this input cross sections, these elementary processes, this nucleon going to nucleon lambda k process. Of course, can be measured. But all other processes where deltas are involved, it is not possible to measure them. So you have to estimate them through some way. And in fact, these cross sections are used by there are many three, four varieties of transport models available. So in all those models, these cross sections are input. So I wonder if these groups can sit together and arrive at one unique cross section for each process that will enter into all the codes. So then it will be possible to compare the predictions of all the codes. Then of course there is an experimental program, a very vigorous experimental program going on, and Yvonne Leifels presented a nice talk on the experimental activity in this area, which nicely complements or supplements the theory which is being done, not only by independent quantum molecular isospin quantum molecular dynamics transport model, but also other transport models. It depends how friendly you are to experimenters. If you are very friendly to experimenters, then they will use your model. They will not go to others. And of course, if you somehow don't please them, then they will just ignore about it. Then fissure studies. In fissure studies, a very nice presentation was made by Professor Emanuele Bardacci. He showed that you use temperature dependent nuclear viscosity in nuclear fission, and then he proposed an alternative experimental approach by using systems of intermediate fissility. Now this is the work, because India, I dare say, is pioneers in fission physics research. The Bhabha Atomic Research Center, the whole nuclear physics program revolves around that. Mass and kinetic energy distribution in reactions that involve these isotopes like hydrosilicon and so on, on uranium at energies around Coulomb barrier. and his goal appears to be that now he can use, you can use this information or the fragment generated in this study to form the heavy earth. This is the update in it. Because in our country also we have a vigorous super heavy element generation. Many people are interested in this. So perhaps this one can sit together with them and try to evolve a joint study. So instrumentation and facility development. So Lola Protina Jill, she presented details of a Khalifa detecting system which will be used in R3B experiment at their facilities. And the heartening news that she gave is that already it will be possible to do some experiment in 2014. Is not too far away. My impression was it is 2017 or 18, but in 2014 already some experiment will be done. Let's hope that it is done. So this is one activity where also we can start up things, because there is a vigorous new star group in this country. They are trying to use the RIB facility at GSI. So they can think of having a joint collaboration. Then there were also presentations made about the IGA, Indian National Gamma Ray Array, by Palit and Murlithar, and they showed that what is the current status of this IGA and how this IGA facility is being moved around the country, and then and hopefully it will find a final parking place where some good nuclear spectroscopy studies can be done. I think that's all that I want to say, because I don't have also that much time to talk. And again, I apologize to all those whose work I may not have included. It doesn't mean that your work is not important. Your work is also very important. But however, the kind of theme that I pointed out in the very beginning, I followed that theme and I tried to see that what that happened in this conference can be utilized to generate collaborations with my foreign colleagues and getting ideas from them or giving them our ideas, and we can start up have a joint program of research. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have
to speak something at this particular stage. Really, I'm really, really very thankful. Poster award.
So the first recipient is Saqib Ahmad. Poster number 56. Is he here?
Saqib, please, you have to come again.
On recent trends in nuclear, basically this is first conference with this kind of, in this particular region, at Chitkara University. This idea basically came into my mind 2 years before, when Center for Nuclear Theory in India was proposed in a meeting held at IIT Roorkee during September 3 to 5, 2010. The purpose was to encourage the individuals working either independently or in a small groups. I have discussed this idea with Professor A.K. Jain, IIT Roorkee, and started to work on this. Ultimately, this year, on March 26, 2012, Chitkara University accepted the proposal. a very short time, 26 March and this November, and gave us a platform to the internationally scholars under a roof. And you can imagine, this is small, time is small. So it was not possible, basically, without the support of our Honorable Chancellor, Dr. Ashok Chitkara, Pro Chancellor Dr. Madhu Chitkara, and Vice Chancellor Brigadier Dr. R.S. Grewal. I am really very thankful to the Professor A.K. Jain, Professor Radhisham, Professor D.K. Srivastava, Professor Vasi Haider sir, and Mr. Dr. P. Arumugam, that gentleman, really, really. And Dr. A. Nasirov from JINR Dubna. I can't forget that help, who helped and supported me continuously during this preparation of this event. I am especially thankful to Dr. S. Kailas, Director of Physics Group, BARC Mumbai, for appreciating the importance of this conference and the need of such kind of events into the particular in this region. The organizer basically acknowledged the Indian government agencies, especially BRNS, Mumbai, CSIR, DRDO, DST, and INSA for their financial support which made this conference a reality. And more important thing is, I am really thankful to the all speaker who presented invited talk for agreeing my request in a very short time. Thanks to them for taking pain in coming to this place for personal interaction with the other participants. Thankful to the registration committee. With those efforts, basically participants has go could not get any difficulty in getting registered at the desk. The participants were properly treated at the registration desk, and also I am thankful to the persons who were involved in the registration of participants for their patience and attitude towards the participants. My special thanks are due to Colonel Y.C. Chibber, who has taken care of all the transportation and your local hospitality, food, etc., along with Professor Varinder Kamar, Professor S.K. Mahajan sir, Dr. Rajneesh Sharma, Colonel Kulwant Singh, Dr. Busra Jaman, Dr. Jigya Sagar. Thanks are due to my dear colleague, Dr. Sitaram, Dr. Lalit Mohan, Dr. Ajay Sharma, Mr. Kuldeep Sharma, Nitin Sharma, Gurjeet, Nirankar, Iswar, Sunil, Jagmohan, Richa, Kanika, Madhu, Neha, Rajni, Sonam, Arpita, Manish. And most important person is Mr. Vidyut Panda, who is sitting back. Because without of that, it was not possible. He basically take care of all the participants. Transportation, hospitality, and really you reduce my
burden
more than 90%. And first day I was comfortable. So due to the shortage of time, it is not possible for me to the name of all those who actively were involved in this organization of this conference. But my sincere thanks are all due to them. Without their efforts and dedication, it was not possible, basically. So this big event could have not been possible. So my sincere gratitude is all towards them. Thanks to all the advisory committee, the organizing committee. If somehow I missed the name, so please ignore me. And really, I am really very thankful to all of you. You came here at this location, at pretty isolated location, and you covered daily that 3 kilometer patch.
Yeah.
And that is really very difficult. So I am really very thankful to all of you. Thank you.
Himachal Pradesh, to once again extend our deepest sense of gratitude to all of you who have taken the trouble of coming not from different corner of India but from different part of the world. The whole credit, I think, goes to the organizer. But what I feel is, without the participation of the delegates, all our efforts would not have borne that fruits which were we were intended to find out. So on behalf of the whole management of Chitkara Education Trust, I again extend my warm this thanks to all of you. I hope a number of speakers, they have taken the trouble to come to this place and enlighten the delegates with various experimental and the theoretical aspects of the nuclear physics. Professor Radhesham has very lucidly explained some of the areas in which most of the nuclear groups, either in experimental or in theoretical physics in India, who could collaborate with their counterparts in other part of the country. And vice versa, if there are certain groups in India also who are active and they have got also a international status as far as their research findings are concerned. So the basic purpose of the international gatherings or the meeting is just to have a knowledge sharing, and with the new IT which is coming, so this has been possible through, say, maybe video conferencing and other, and lot of because when we go for the theoretical type of a calculations and when we have to go deep into the nucleus, so maybe the computational facilities at some part of our country may not be as up to date as it is there in the other countries. So therefore, one can always take the help of NKN, which have been referred in the very beginning, National Knowledge Network, where cloud computing and all other things are available. So one can always look for that. So, but in order to jump into that, one has to dream high and see what is possible at other part of the country, other part of the world, can be done. We should have some motive or objective of doing those things. And as rightly have been said by Professor Radhesham, that some of the experimental facilities in India we are lacking. So we must make use of all those facilities which are available abroad. And this is these types of the platforms gives us the opportunity to interact and plan our small or a bigger group, and then we start working on that. So without not taking much of your time, I hope you had a wonderful stay here. And if there have been, we have tried our level best, we are located at a very remote place, and we have tried to make you as comfortable as possible. But still, in spite of that, if there are shortcomings on our part, so kindly bear with us and excuse us for any thing which we could not provide you. So with these words, and looking forward for many such interaction, and I hope when you go back, you will not forget Chitkara University, Himachal Pradesh. And in all your future research endeavors, conferences, you will make it a point that you send us invitations, and so that we can send our scientists from this place to the various other place. So thank you very much once again to one and all. Thank you.
बाहर हो जाए
ग्रुप फोटो
बाहर हो जाए किथे रखा
Yeah, wait.
ज्यादा ना जाएं
सेंटर में जाओ
फ्लैश बंद करो जी
Wait, wait.
Okay, मेरा पास